Am I the a-hole for asking my sister-in-law if she didn't want kids? Why did she get pregnant? So this title is bad, I acknowledge this, but allow me to introduce you to my sister-in-law, Laurel. Laurel married my brother around 5 years ago. They had always been child-free and extremely proud of it, which I'm to a point. She has always been disparaging of children and the idea of children, and consistently would judge other mothers around us for how they handled their own kids. She would comment rude things about people who would breastfeed in public, or even be bold enough to tell them, "You should cover up because my husband can see you too." Overall, Laurel doesn't like kids. Well, guess what? Laurel is pregnant now. And both her and my brother planned this pregnancy, so it's not an accident. The family was very excited, but Laurel has made a misery out of the entire pregnancy. And to be honest, we know she plans to make a misery out of her poor kid's life as well. The baby is a girl, and she'll say things like, "I don't want to deal with her long hair, so I'll shave it off to keep it maintainable." Or, "I hate dresses. I'll never let her wear those." She refuses to let us buy the baby toys or anything enjoyable, saying that the child won't want those till they're like 3 years old. I don't even like babies, but I know that's a complete lie. I finally snapped when she was at a family dinner. She kept telling us how terrible it was to have to get the baby's room ready, and how she hated having to buy everything for it. How this kid was already so expensive and wasn't even here yet, and making her life miserable. I asked her why she got pregnant if she didn't want this kid. That was a bowling ball catastrophe, and even though my brother often tells me he asks the same thing, apparently Laurel doesn't like getting called out about her behavior toward her unborn child. Am I the a-hole for asking her if she didn't want kids, why did she get pregnant? Edit. Something else I'd like to add. Laurel's currently 35. She isn't young, and neither is my brother. Now for the top comments. Not the a-hole. For Pete's sake, somebody had to ask. How does the brother not even know? How did this not come up during the planning? This isn't even an elephant in the room. It's a blue whale. Oh, he knows. He's just not talking for some reason. Not today, home. She has his balls in her purse. This is a situation ripe for child mistreatment. Opie should have CPS on speed dial, ready to push that button the moment they suspect the kid is being mistreated. Not today, home. But please plan on being the most awesome auntie ever. I have a feeling your niece will need someone in her life desperately. Heck yeah. Even if Laurel decides to cut it off with me, and by extension my brother because she has him in her pocket, I'll always be here for that kid in the future. Next story. Am I the a-hole for moving to avoid adopting my niece? My cousin had been on a bit of a wild child strike and ended up in prison. She got out and had her daughter, which made everyone think she's going to get it together. Well, she didn't. And my aunt had to take over all the parenting duties to keep CPS from taking her away. My aunt is now in her 50s and not healthy enough to care for my niece, who has started acting out in the same way as her mother. My cousin flits in and out of my niece's life and taken her back occasionally, only to bring her back to my aunt when she can't handle her anymore. The child has been in juvie already, and it seems she's going the same way as my cousin. My aunt is running out of options as my niece runs around town, and she isn't healthy enough to drive around searching for her in the middle of the night. So my aunt is trying to get the rest of the family to take care of her, but everyone refuses. My aunt is now pressuring me to adopt my cousin, who is 14. She doesn't mean legally, but to assume responsibility until the age of 18. My family is also taken to pressuring me since it will mean the pressure is taken off them. Also, most of them have person problems, kids. I don't want my niece to ruin their kids, while I don't have any. I absolutely don't want to. I don't want my cousin in my life, which will be inevitable if I adopt my niece. And my niece? She's basically my cousin on steroids. I have no idea how my cousin and niece ended up so messed up, and I don't want to wait to see my own life be ruined if I have to take care of my niece. Hell, I resisted not getting a dog during the pandemic because I couldn't commit to one long term, so there's no way I can commit to a child. I get emails and texts, and my aunt's banging on my door semi-frequently, once a week, dragging my niece in tow trying to get me to let her in. I have literally been in tears begging them to leave me alone. But we all live 2 to 3 hours away from each other, and only my mom is telling me not to do it. My boyfriend noticed the craziness from my family, and the midnight phone calls from my aunt trying to get me to come pick her up, and ask what we should do. I told him I just didn't want to be involved, and he suggested we move. We've been thinking of moving for a while now, actually. His family's in Oregon, and I've been thinking of moving for a few years, His family has a house that they are trying to rent out, and we could try there for a few weeks. We did that, and we're now in Oregon. I know my family aren't going to chase me here, and it's quiet. We went back to Arkansas for a few days to pack up what's left and visit some old friends. Somehow, someone let it slip I was coming because my aunt is at my door screaming at me for leaving without a word. My boyfriend calls his friend to come help us take the rest of our stuff, and we leave. Then I see my aunt drop to her knees crying, and now I feel horrible since she's such a proud woman, and I've never seen her like this. I know what's best for me, not adopting my niece, but am I the a-hole here? 100% not the a-hole. In my opinion, what she is asking you is completely insane. Do not feel bad. You did what you had to do. Your aunt is in a horrible situation, but it is not your fault and not your responsibility to fix. My family is also taken to pressuring me since it will mean the pressure is taken off them. Definitely not day home. Notice how everyone else wants you to do it, so they don't have to. You made a right choice. This reminds me of a saying I once heard. Raise your kids right or raise your grandkids. Sounds like she's trying to foist a grandkid onto someone else after failing to raise her own kid. Not today, home. Sorry you had to get run out of your own home to avoid all this crazy. But on the upside, Oregon is a nice place. Underrated wine country too. Also, do try to find out who the rat is that told your aunt had cut them out like cancer. Not today, home. Your cousin's child is not your child and not your responsibility. I feel sorry for this girl as her mother has clearly done a number on her. She may also be acting out because she feels like no one wants her. As tragic as that is, again, this is not a burden that you should have to assume. Now for the next story. Am I the a-hole for turning my plate around after being served dinner by my mother-in-law? My husband, 29 male and I, 23 female, have been married for a year, but have been together for almost 3 years now. We are currently staying with my in-laws for 2 weeks, whilst our house gets painted. My sister-in-law and her husband and 2 kids are also living with my in-laws as well. Sadly, my mother-in-law doesn't like me very much, as she wanted my husband to marry one of her friend's daughter, who was also his ex, but I still try to be as friendly as possible with her, since she is my husband's mother. I just want to add that we could have stayed in a hotel, but my mother-in-law insisted that my husband stay with them. So, I was helping my mother-in-law cook dinner. We made a simple dish of salmon and some veggies, and she plated the food and placed them on the dinner table whilst I were making our dessert. I had made an apple crumble beforehand, but it was too sweet for her liking, so she told me to make it again. After we all sat down to eat, I noticed the way my plate was oriented, and the salmon was on the right and the veggies were on the left. For nearly everyone, this isn't a big deal and wouldn't bother them. But I have a bit of a quirk that my meat slash fish should always be on the left, and any vegetables or sides should be on the right. It's very hard to explain, but unless I move my food around so that the meat is on the left and anything else is on the right, I find it very hard to eat and swallow. To solve this issue, I just turned my plate in 180 degrees so that the salmon would be on the left and the veggies on the right. I didn't say anything or make any expression, but my mother-in-law noticed me turning my plate around and start to blow up. She said that moving something that was already set on the table was bad manners, and couldn't believe how rude I was being in her house. I apologized and tried to explain that I just had this thing where one thing needs to be on a certain side, but she interrupted me and went on a tangent saying that this shows how immature I am, and that my husband's ex never behaved like this. My husband tried to calm her down, saying that we shouldn't argue whilst having dinner, but then she started complaining about how I couldn't cook, because whilst making dinner together, she kept having a problem with how big I cut the veggies, even though they were perfectly normal-sized, and how bad of a wife I was for not being able to do simple things. Throughout the entire meal, she kept complaining, and I felt horrible and was pretty much on the verge of tears. My sister-in-law later told me that her kids are more mature than I am, and my husband also got annoyed at me, and said it ruined dinner for the whole family. This whole mess could have been avoided if I had done nothing. I now feel horrible for ruining dinner, especially since my husband works a lot and doesn't see his family often. Now for the comments. Not today, home, but your mother-in-law, sister-in-law, and dear husband are. They sound like toxic people. Your husband should have your back here. Go stay in a hotel. For your sanity, if anything. And find a good divorce lawyer as well. This is mistreatment. What a horribly vindictive family, and how incredibly telling it is for your husband to gang up on you. All because you turned your plate around? Turned your plate around. What planet are these people from where turning your plate around is even noticed? This was absolutely a setup by mother-in-law, who intended to do this to you so she could bring up the ex. And sister-in-law took the opportunity to make you feel worse, and your husband piled on the first opportunity. Unless he's willing to go through some serious therapy to fix these massive issues, you will eventually divorce. I would cut my losses at this point if he isn't immediately, genuinely, and completely apologetic. You have done nothing wrong in this, even if you had cut the vegetables wrong. Not stay home. Your mother-in-law and sister-in-law are looking for an excuse to put you down. It didn't matter if you were perfect, they would have found something. I'm more concerned that your husband didn't 100% have your back while you were being mistreated by his family. I know you didn't ask for advice, but this sounds like it could be a very troublesome marriage. Next story. Am I the a-hole for telling my sister that her infertility is not my problem? I'm 18 female and 34 weeks pregnant. My sister is 35 female and suffers with infertility. She has no kids and is starting to look into adoption. When I told her I was pregnant, she immediately started going crazy. She said it's not fair, that I'm abusing my fertility, and that I should give my baby up because I have life to live. It's been like this my entire pregnancy. Most recently, she started asking me if I want to try a co-parenting relationship with her, where I give her my baby 2 days of the week and make her a legal custodian. I said no to this one too. She also keeps asking me to adopt my baby to her, and it's just not happening. She came over for brunch this morning and brought up the idea of her adopting my baby. I am very much prepared for. This time, I snapped and said to her, "I don't understand what it's like not to be able to have children, but your fertility is not my problem to solve, and I am not giving you my child. Please don't push me." Everyone in the room thinks I am the a-hole for this, and my parents are giving me the cold shoulder for being so insensitive. Am I the a-hole? Not the a-hole. Do not let your sister babysit. Do not leave her alone with your child. 1 million times this. This is a true crime documentary waiting to happen. I think there was an episode like this of Twisted Sisters on Discovery ID. There was. She found out her sister was pregnant, lied to her husband that she was pregnant too, faked her entire pregnancy, gave birth alone a few days after her sister, then took her sister and new baby on a drive, offed her sister with a rock to the head and pushed her over a bridge. She took the baby home, and her husband returned, who then called the police when he realized the baby looked an awful lot like her sister's. She had blood on her and was not acting normal. Not day hall, because how many times do you have to say no? Tell her to accept the no and move on, because if she doesn't, then you're done talking to her until she does. Your parents are trying to comfort her, but not realizing they're just not acting right towards you. Talk to them. Tell them you shouldn't have to keep hearing it from her over and over again. Congratulations on your baby. Edited to add, I agree with others who have said to please do not ever leave your baby with your sister. She sounds desperate enough to take the baby and run. Yeah, no. You're not an a-hole for not giving away your child. How the hell does that even sound? How does this even cross someone's mind? This is so crazy to the point it sounds a little bit unreal. Not an a-hole. Given the fact that she's literally trying to beg, buy, or steal your baby, what you said is mild. Struggling with infertility is rough. I hope your sister recognizes that she needs therapy to cope, because she's clearly not coping well. Last story is titled, Am I the a-hole for telling my sister she won't get to babysit again while her boyfriend is around? I have a 4-year-old daughter and a 2-year-old son. I have a younger sister who about a year ago started dating a guy I went to high school with. The guy was not a good guy then, and he got into trouble, was arrested, treated others terribly, and did some things that show he is not a good person to have around kids. My sister is normally a really reliable and trustworthy person, but her taste in men has never been good. She dated a guy who had kids, didn't take care of them, and wanted to marry him. She dated a dealer for a while. She dated a guy who went to prison 2 months in and stayed with him for a few months after his release because she didn't believe his stealing from his brother's girlfriend was enough reason to break up. This current guy is still rough around the edges, to say the least. I met him twice since, and the second time, he tried to pick a fight with my husband because they disagreed on a video game and he, sister's boyfriend, was mad. We're talking real mad, to the point my husband had to just leave. My sister had babysat a couple of times for us in the past, and she loved doing it. Then 2 weekends ago, my husband and I were having a night out with friends. She offered to babysit, But I said it was okay, we already had plans made, which was true, but those plans were my husband's parents were out of the way. My sister realized this after my daughter told her that grandma gave her ice cream for dinner. My sister was hurt that I didn't make the easy decision for her. I told her I didn't feel comfortable leaving my kids with her while her boyfriend is around. She told me I judge him too hard. We talked at length about him before. She claims he has changed, that he was always misunderstood, etc. I told her she wasn't in school with him, and she didn't see his crap on a daily basis back then. I also pointed out his reaction over a video game disagreement, but she said he was just having a bad day. So I told her I wouldn't want him having a bad day around my kids. She said I should still trust her and rely on her to take care of my kids. I told her there will be no babysitting for her while he's around. She said he's going to be their uncle, so I better get used to him being around. Am I the a-hole? Not the a-hole. People change from high school, but he clearly still has anger issues if he actually gets mad about a disagreement about video games. Opie has a duty to protect her children. I'd rather have hurt feelings than put my kids in a potentially dangerous situation. I told her I wouldn't want him having a bad day around my kids. Exactly my thoughts. If he blows up about video games and wants to fight a grown man, he's very likely to blow up at smaller annoyances. And kids, while I love them, can be annoying. Not day home. Keep them away from him. Not day home. She said he's going to be their uncle, so I better get used to him being around. Okay, she can marry whoever she wants. You can assign whoever you want as a babysitter.